just tape them into your sketchbook so that way you guys have them for future reference. A lot of really valuable information here, so you want to keep it. We are about to go over it almost word for word, but I know you guys can read, so I'm not going to go over every single word. You may want to put that somewhere so you don't get chalk. That's it. Can you mix the two?
No,
is the correct answer.
No, I mean,
technically you can do whatever you want in the world, but...
You shouldn't.
They don't blend well. As opposed to, like, if you're using soft and hard chalk pastels. Those go very well together. They are intended to go together. And there's also a chalk pencil that you can use, a chalk pastel pencil that also blends very, very well with the chalk pastels. So if you're mixing oils with the chalk, it's just going to come like a big gunky mess. So I don't really recommend it. But anyways, so let's look at this lovely handout that we have in front of us. It kind of starts out by going over the differences of what I just said, the hard versus soft pastel. Whenever me and Ms. Suter talking about pastels, you're going to hear us refer to them as drawings and paintings. So the difference between drawings and paintings, a drawing is kind of like you can still see paintings or drawings. And so I've got a few examples. Both of those images that are on this piece of paper are what I would call stylized. So it's kind of, you know, like the still life here is very gestural. We've got some light that they've just come and like painted on some pure white pastel. These darker colors, you can see that purple in. That outline looks like a nice, really dark black. So, you know, normally whenever we're painting, we're mixing those to create those colors. So I did one this weekend. This is my dog, Yuki. She is the love of my life. So you guys can see that like I've got purple in there, which kind of creates this illusion of this really dark tone. I tried to use black in some areas, but it doesn't read as dark as like those purples do. So you might be exaggerating some colors. This is kind of what I mean by stylized. So I'm also, you know, like her nose isn't necessarily white like I've got this in here, but I didn't have like the oranges, like a light orangey white color. Like I had to kind of fake it to create the illusion that like this is different than this color on her face. So you guys can see. And then also you can see like the different drawing techniques that I'm doing. Like I'm doing cross hatching, I'm doing stippling in some areas. Like I'm doing all these different techniques we're about to go over to create one image. So we're gonna go over techniques individually here in a minute, and you don't have to only use one technique on whatever your final artwork is. I was literally just saying. Oh my gosh. All right, so do I need to take these away from you? We need to put these over here? Okay, all right, we'll put these over here. All right. Like I was saying, so whenever you guys, like as you can see, like pastels get all over you everywhere and they smudge and everything. So whenever you guys are storing these, like make sure you don't put stuff on top of it because it will come off onto whatever object is on top of it. And you may just, you know, smear a lot of the wood up and down, scrub things. And then that is going to blend those colors. So I'm really scrubbing in the middle and then I'm kind of coming back to those outer areas and doing them a little separate so they stay more pure of their original color. And then I'm gonna come back on top just to make them a little bit more, like so there's a more obvious contrast happening between these colors. So I came back with that turquoise and the purple and make, so that way it's very obvious where your starting color is and your other color, and you can see how they change colors in the middle. So that's blending. All right, so the next one we do, everyone feel confident in that?
Beautiful.
Sure. Excellent. I'm sure.
That's amazing.
Small stroke.
So the next one is a small stroke. So this one, as you can guess, is just a whole bunch of small strokes. So if you need to, you want to, It may be best to just try a different color instead of just trying to erase. So keep that in mind. Also, if you haven't yet, grab one of the blending sticks and see what happens if you are, you know, manipulate some of those lines on there. Specifically on this next one, we're going to do the last one. We're almost done, you guys. Thanks for sticking with me. So this last one is drawing, and that is simply like, you know, like drawing. So you can use the, you know, like it's just a line, just a bunch of lines. Which you guys know a drawing
is. So I can draw a dog.
You draw a dog,
yeah. Oh, that's horrible.
So this technique might be really nice, like if you're blending and like, you know, you're doing your side strokes to create like a nice smooth texture, and then you need to come back and you need to draw some line detail, like maybe there's a, I don't know, face of a clock. You can come back with a just a straight up pastel and draw your numbers on there, or draw your face details. So, or, you know, you can also draw with the pastel to do your underdrawing to kind of get your preliminary sketches down so you know what you're going to do. All right, any questions? Thank you. So you guys are really good about all those different techniques that we just went over. We're going to open up our sketchbooks to a brand new page. And we are going to apply these sketches, these little techniques that we've gone over. So don't get these pages, these note pages, don't get them lost with the texture pages that I have in the middle of your table. You have to keep these. Please keep these. Please keep these. So yeah, so on in the middle of your table, you have a big old cluster of various textures. You can borrow some of your table if you want. Or I've got like another second one. So you've got these different textures on your table. They are all different styles of surfaces. And you guys are going to use, well, it's the next 5 minutes. You can do it. You can totally do it. I believe in you. So you're gonna choose one of the textures that you think would be best for that specific texture that you choose. So you guys have 5 minutes to try and best recreate that texture with the different styles of application learned. So guys, not only you're gonna have your sketch in your sketchbook, you're going to have the number of the image. And you're also going to have the names of the techniques that you used on that image. So what do I need? What do I want from this?
I don't know.
Texture.
And the names.
Number of the names.
Technique names. Yes. Try and get three. See if you can get three from one picture. Yes.
Primary purpose is for blending, but you know, be creative. I should have listened
to me, but I put my hand right here.
See, yeah, I'm a lefty, and like everything that I draw or paint just schmears.
Make sure that you've got the name of the different techniques that you've used and write it down. Yeah, washing hands first. Yeah, guys, I think class is almost done.
26.
Okay, yeah. So, guys, you want to start cleaning up, maybe add the final touches to whatever you're working on. And we want these areas to be clean and pristine before we leave. There's dust everywhere. We don't want it on anyone's clothes. Also, make sure you have the number of the reference image you used and the different techniques that you used written with your sketch.
That's great.
So guys, we have Clorox wipes over here, so make sure your table is wiped down before you leave. I want to make sure that every table is wiped before you can go.
Why did I do that?